Hi, I'm Jim White. Welcome to another edition of the Dinner Club, and tonight a special event at Smoke at the Belmont Hotel. Get ready to enjoy some great wines from Rioja.
Hi, I'm Adrian Murcia, and we're here tonight at Smoke Restaurant in Dallas. We're tasting five different Rioja wines. Really a nice selection of Riojas to see all the diversity that is available in this part of Spain. This is north central Spain, about 500 different wineries. We've got a small slice of that, but I think a really nice cross section. We've got a couple of larger bodegas, Lan. We're tasting a Reserva 2006 from them, a blend of Tempranillo and other red grapes from the area. The second wine we're tasting tonight is another Reserva from Marques de Cáceres, which is a super pioneering bodega in Rioja, because they were the first to introduce temperature-controlled stainless steel fermentation. Up next, Bodegas Muga. Now, Muga kind of also splits the difference, but they make some wines in the traditional style and some wines in the modern style. This particular wine we're tasting tonight, the Muga Reserva, is made in a more traditional sense. Instead of fermenting in stainless steel, the wines are fermented in oak. Moving on, we're tasting two of Rioja's top modern winemakers. First is Artadi, which is Viñas da Gaín, which is their entry-level wine, but still, you have to think, an entry-level wine made from only a handful of vineyards owned by the winery that are at least 40 years old. Everything is, all the grapes are hand sorted, and everything is fermented in oak and then aged in oak. Our last wine is Bodegas Roda. It's a Reserva, and Roda is a newcomer to the scene in Rioja. What I find interesting about this is that he's sort of preserving something from the past, but also making a wine that's very much of the moment in Rioja, and which is, I think, a nice metaphor for what's going on in Rioja right now.
When we started the restaurant, you know, the idea was to have fun, to really create an environment where there's a lot of change, a lot of things going on. So, I mean, we're constantly developing new stuff and having a good time at the restaurant, and, part of the original goal was to do this kind of genuine, real, and honest kind of food and restaurant stuff. So it has been a lot of fun. This is definitely different than other places I've worked in. We're having a good time every day.
It's a wine that is often compared to Pinot Noir or Sangiovese, which are the wines from Burgundy and Chianti, respectively, as wines that won't overwhelm you when you're drinking it because they are lighter, because they're a little bit earthier, and because they really go well with food.
First course is going to be a smoked pork chow bacon with fermented pickles, some sweet garden peppers, molasses and mustard. And then we're doing a spicy lamb meatball with a pasilla chili mole and golden raisin chutney.
It reminds me a little bit of a foie gras meatball I had in northern Spain in Bilbao, that it kind of just sort of melts in your mouth. It's perfectly cooked. What is it about meatballs that are just so lovable?
That is really gross.
And then we have kind of a smoked beef two ways. So we've got a dry rub beef short rib with a smoked fennel seed and paprika sausage, beef sausage, and some stone ground cheese grits with fresh herbs and chimichurri.
No, it's all about Tempranillo. There are a couple other grapes that they used, or Grenache being one of them, but it's mainly Tempranillo.
And then we have our drunken pecan tart. So this is kind of bourbon cherries with a molasses and caramel pecan tart and gorgonzola cheese.